And I'd like for you to meet a special guest. Jules Shepard is very much into gluten-free cooking.
That's right.
She has several books, two books, and a new flour that she has started. Yep. And let me ask you, why did you decide to eat gluten-free?
Well, actually, it's a good question, because a lot of people are concerned about gluten in their diets in general. But I was actually diagnosed with celiac disease in the 90s. And when I was told I had celiac disease, I had to figure out what that meant. Yeah. And what that means is you have to avoid gluten in everything that you eat. It's an autoimmune disease where your body misinterprets the gluten, which is in wheat and barley and rye, things that most people eat all the time. And if you eat that, it triggers this disease. So I had to avoid it entirely, which is what caused me to create my own flour and all these other recipes to make foods that actually tasted like normal food. Because originally, back, you know, in the dark ages of gluten-free, things tasted really, really bad.
Well, this is a graham cracker. And let me tell you, it's good.
Yeah, it should taste just like a graham cracker. And the neat thing about that recipe, it's one of my favorite recipes, because you could serve it to just about anybody. It's not just gluten-free, but it's egg-free and dairy-free and soy-free and nut-free. So it's really nice to have at parties and things where you're not really sure what other food allergens people might be sensitive to. And it's great for kids. I mean, kids love graham crackers. And so you could serve that to just about anybody.
What else do you have here?
Well, these are some lemon poppy seed muffins. And these are the vanilla wafers that I'm making here today, just homemade vanilla wafers. And then what I did was I used these little guys here. I just took a little vanilla wafer and I used it in the bottom of these little cupcake tins to make little mini cheesecakes for entertaining. It's so easy. You just plop one of these guys in the bottom as the crust, make your cheesecake, and go.
Now, how can people get in touch with you?
My website, julesglutenfree.com, and also, obviously, my books and things like that. So
you have two books. Let's talk about them again. The name?
Yeah. The first book that came out in 2006 is Nearly Normal Cooking for Gluten-Free Eating. The next book that came out is all about celiac disease and how to live gluten-free, which is the first year of celiac disease. And then I have another book coming out this year as well, another cookbook. And it's got a lot of food allergens in it, too.
I would imagine that there's some doctors that do not diagnose the condition. What are some of the symptoms? So if someone is listening and they have the symptoms.
Yeah. Well, it can actually be almost anything. I mean, it's an autoimmune disease, as I mentioned, but it's mostly gastrointestinal. But it can manifest itself in anything. You could have iron deficiency anemia. You could have osteoporosis. You could have migraine headaches. All kinds of things that are sort of mysterious. If you have something like that that is not otherwise diagnosed, it's nice to just throw that into your blood work and see whether maybe or not that
could be the research,
problem.
How much research did you have to do to find out this is what it is? And then when you're putting your book together, because I have a friend who's very sensitive, and it's tough.
Yeah, it really is hard. But we're very fortunate where we live here, because the University of Maryland Center for Celiac Research is the preeminent center in the country. And it actually is right there in Baltimore. And May is Celiac Awareness Month.
So. Jules Shepard.
Yeah, thank you. Thanks
Gluten
for having
free.
Me.
Thank you for being
sure,
with
yeah,
us.
Enjoy.
These are delicious.
Thank
Come
you.
Back and join us
thank
at
you.
5 p.m. Taste it, Howard. It's very good.
Taste it.